If you work on a Mac, these six apps can help you get your work done faster. And you don't have to worry about downloading them or figuring out if they're worth the price. You already have them on your computer. That's right, today I'm going to tell you about six useful productivity apps that already come with your Mac, hiding in the Applications and the Utilities folders. If you have the Finder open, you can just hit Shift-Command-A or Shift-Command-U to bring up these really quick. And I'm going to start with number one, Stickies. Now, there are a lot of people who I know and love, despite the fact that they cover their computer monitor with sticky notes. And really, why limit yourself to the outer bounds? You can cover your digital desktop as well with little post-it notes using Stickies. You just hit Command-N to bring up a new note, and you can go through Command 1 through 6 to change the color. You can put little snippets of text, you can drop in images, you can drag it around on the screen, you can resize it, and even though all of your sticky notes are saved when you quit and reopen the app, if there's something maybe more permanent you put in there that you want to save elsewhere, you can go to File, Export All to Notes, this will add them in the Notes app where it'll sync across all your devices, or you can export it to a text file on your hard drive. Now, you may be wondering, what are all these weird buttons on the top? Why doesn't it have the standard, like, three close, minimize, maximize buttons that every other Mac app has? Well, this is actually because Stickies is, believe it or not, one of the oldest apps on the Mac that has remained virtually unchanged since its debut in Macintosh System 7.5, all the way back in the early 90s. The square button on the left closes the window, the line button on the right is called Window Shade. Instead of minimizing to the dock, it rolls up the window into its title bar and it sort of stays in place, leaving this little stick on your screen. But for some reason, all these controls just stuck around as is. They never changed it. Number two, Digital Color Meter. If you're making a presentation or whipping up some graphics, you might want to get the exact color of something else on the screen. Now you can take a screenshot, you can import that screenshot into a photo editing app, you can get the eyedropper tool, you can pick it up, and then you can copy all the color codes, or you can just use Digital Color Meter. You just hover the cursor over what you're looking at, it'll tell you all the color codes, and you can just hit Command-L to lock it in place. You can hit Shift-Command-C to copy the color code, or you can do Option-Command-C to copy a little image of it. You can increase the sample size to a larger area of pixels and get the average value. You can switch between decimal and hexadecimal, and you can switch between color profiles like P3 and sRGB. Number three, your Mac comes with a built-in dictionary, thesaurus, and Wikipedia reader. It is a lightning-fast way to look things up. You just hit Command Space for Spotlight, type in the first few letters, hit Enter, and you start typing in a word, and you'll instantly get results. And it's an excellent way to read Wikipedia. You have all the inline links, images, tables, and because it's inside the dictionary app, you can click on any word to get a definition. Number four, screen sharing. If you have multiple Macs in your office, screen sharing will be your new best friend. It doesn't matter if your MacBook lid is closed or your Mac Mini doesn't even have a display connected. You can use screen sharing to remotely control your other computer from your own. You just need to make sure it's turned on first. On a newer Mac, that's in System Settings, General, Sharing, and you can turn it on from there. On an older Mac, that's System Preferences, Sharing. If it's a Mac on the same network, just go to Network in the sidebar, hover the mouse over the Connect button, then you'll enter in the username and password on that Mac, and then you'll instantly be able to control the screen as if it was your own. You can connect to a truly remote Mac across the internet by clicking the plus icon in the toolbar. You can enter in either the Apple ID or the hostname if you know that, and that'll send an invitation. Number five, Grapher. If you need help on your math homework, be it algebra or calculus or whatever fresh hell requires a polar logarithmic graph, Grapher can help you make 2D and 3D graphs with a wide selection of units and templates. You type in your equation on the top, you hit this sigma button to add features like roots, summations, and integrals. You can stack several different equations on the same graph by clicking this plus in the bottom of the sidebar, and you just click on any plot on the graph and click the inspector to edit the line color and the thickness. Now, if you want to see the extreme of what's possible, I highly encourage you to look at the examples in the menu bar. There are some wild graphs in there. Now, you may be wondering, why does Apple make a graphing calculator? It is a wild story that involves two contractors who had their projects canceled, who decided to keep coming into work, sneaking into the building, taking up vacant offices so they could work on this without any pay for 6 months, and sneaking it into the next release of macOS. It is crazy. You can read the full article over here. Number 6, screenshot. Now you might remember that Shift-Command-3 is the keyboard shortcut to take a screenshot on the Mac, or more likely you Google it every time. Well, if you have space for one and only one keyboard shortcut in your brain, I want you to remember Shift-Command-5. That brings up the screenshot app, which gives you a user-friendly interface for all of the different kinds of ways you can screenshot and capture your screen. You have these simple buttons you can click for capturing the whole screen, a portion of the screen, a specific window, and you have this little options menu that gives you all of the different options that come with that. Like, for example, you can take a screen recording with live audio from your microphone baked into the video. And yes, I wrote a full article on all of the features in the screen recording app that you can find in this article here. So if you learned something from this video, be sure to like and subscribe. There are even more useful applications in there, like Fontbook, that's an easy way to view and edit the fonts installed in your computer. Activity Monitor shows you which apps are taking up a bunch of system resources that maybe shouldn't. Disk Utility is an easy way to manage the disks and storage attached to your Mac. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.